Excuse me.
All right.
You're the lawyer?
Yeah, it's David.
Okay, I need some legal advice.
Well, my advice should be get a lawyer. That's not very funny. What can I help you with?
Well, I purchased something, and it turned out to be not at all what I wanted.
Really? Well, then did you try taking it back or asking the place for the money back?
That's kind of hard to do. It's impossible, really. It's a tattoo.
You got a tattoo that you're not happy with?
Yeah, I think I want to sue. Could you just have a look?
Yeah, sure. Oh, no, I'm married. I mean, I'm going to be married. I mean, I have a date to be married. I mean, I'm not really taking on any new clients right now, is what I'm saying.
Well, I mean, just have a look at it. I mean, maybe you'll change your mind.
All right.
Okay.
How much further are we going here?
Almost there.
Okay. Congrats, Eddie.
I got you, Eddie! I got you!
My brother Lloyd. There he is.
Oh, the tattoo was my idea.
Pretty strong, brother.
Yeah.
Pretty strong. I wasn't expecting you for a week.
Well, it's just one of the surprises. Here's one of the other surprises. Go ahead, Chrissy, give the groom to be the man now.
She brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than
the wow. Oh, look at you. It's very impressive. We'll pass on the business briefly for now. Thank you.
No, listen to him. He loves it.
Hi. Just stop for a second. No offense.
What are you, crazy?
No, I'm not, Floyd.
I'm only here to help you celebrate your wedding, Eddie. But if that's the way you want it. Do you have any, good. You're the guy every girl's looking for.
Boy. No, I'm saying, hey, look, attention, single women of Stuckeyville, I got some bad news for you. Eddie Stevens, Stuckeyville's most eligible bachelor, is off the market.
Boy.
You had your chance, but you blew it.
Boy.
You blew it.
Boy.
Come on.
You gotta give them a chance to learn from their mistakes. You owe them that much. I wish I had your life. Everything comes so easy for you.
Wouldn't say easy, exactly.
What are you talking about? You got a great career, and now Carol, everything just falls in your lap.
Well, if it falls in my lap, I mean, working hard through 7 years of college and the endless enough and painful pursuit of the woman I love, I guess you could say it falls in my lap. Is that the kind of falls in my lap you're talking about?
All right, don't be like that. Forget I said anything, all right? I'm not coming to the wedding.
What is it?
I mean, I want to. I'd love to. It's killing me. It's just I got this thing came up. Big business opportunity.
This is my wedding. You're my brother.
Go ahead, tell me that, buddy. It's just, you know, opportunity doesn't come my way that often. I can't pass this up.
What? When do you have to be wherever this opportunity is?
Yeah, it's one of those sooner's better than later kind of things. I'm sorry. But hey, listen, I hate to ask you this, but I got a little favor.
How much?
So what do you mean? Wait, how much? It's not about money. Why is it always about money with you? I need you to store a few things for me until I get back, that's all.
You want me to store a few things?
Yeah.
A few things?
Yeah.
All right.
Thanks, buddy.
Welcome.
Get married. Eddie's getting married. I'm so happy for you.
You hate it, don't you?
Calm down. Everything's fine.
Hurry up and get out here. You're making me nervous.
Okay. Needs to be hemmed a little, but... What?
You look amazing. You know what? We might actually have to change that.
Oh, please. The moment you step in the church, it's gonna be Stella who?
And is that why you're not bringing a date?
No. I wasn't sure I could. I didn't know how ugly the bridesmaids' dresses were gonna be.
Ha-ha. Wow, look at you. What did I tell you? I told you you were gonna be beautiful.
Oh, I have something for you. Go on, open it.
It was Mom's.
I thought it could be your something old.
Thank you. I needed this.
Congratulations, Erin. The first patient I've had has developed tennis elbow from actually playing tennis.
Badminton.
Excuse me?
Badminton. You said I play tennis, but I play badminton.
Uh-huh. Well, just put some ice on the next time it acts up, okay? Mr. Sabatino, you're up. Come this way, please.
Dr. Burton, a moment, please.
Give me just a moment, Mr. Sabatino.
You have a lot of very sick people to take care of today, Dr. Burton.
Not really. Some tendonitis, Mr. Sabatino, just getting a checkup.
Yeah, I'm speaking of those patients who are soon going to fall victim to that cloud of germs you're spewing forth.
Oh, it's just a case of the sniffles.
I am not a veterinarian, son. I do not have the wherewithal to treat all of these people when they come back in here with whatever strain of baboon flu you might have given them.
Maybe I should have taken a sick day, but we've been so busy here, I just thought...
Therein lies the problem. How many times do I have to tell you that you are not the brains of this operation? You are the beast who pulls the cart upon which I, the medicine man, ride.
So I should just go home and you'll handle things here?
You're a donkey.
Thank you.
Eddie! I'll be the son of a sea cook. I thought you said it was a few things.
Yeah, I gave up my apartment. No point in paying rent if I'm not going to be living in the place. Is this a problem, Eddie? Because you got all this space, but if it's a problem.
Oh, no, no problem, Mr. Passive Aggressive. How long do I got to hold on this stuff for?
Well, it's been quite a while. Hey, Eddie, you know I said I wasn't going to borrow any money or anything?
Yeah, how much?
No, not as a gift. Here's what I was thinking. You could have a sale. You could sell my stuff. Oh, you'll probably even come out ahead. I mean, look at this, Eddie.
That's an old lamp.
Oh, it's an old lamp because you call it an old lamp.
It's like an old lamp.
No, but if you call it an antique, look what happens. You know, people gobble up antiques.
I'm not selling your stuff.
Oh, no, come on, Eddie. No, look, you can sell it all, right? You can sell everything but this.
Oh, the Johnny Bench autographed baseball. Oh, now that is, that is sweet. Oh, that'd be worth something.
No, this you can't sell.
Can't sell. I remember when you got this. Remember 75 playoffs? You, me, and Dad? Big red machine. That was awesome.
Hey, hang on to it for me till I get back, okay?
Yeah, all right.
Where are you going?
I'm hanging on to the ball.
No, you gotta help me with the stuff, Eddie.
You told me to hang on to the ball, Lloyd.
No, you gotta help me with the stuff.
Stella? Honey, it's me. You said you'd help me with the seating.
Hi.
Here, got you some tea.
Thank you.
So, I'm thinking that maybe a sweetheart's table isn't the best idea and that Ed and I should just sit with the wedding party anyway. Although, if we sit with the wedding party, we don't actually get to see anybody in the wedding party unless you lean forward and backward. Sweetheart's table does have the advantage of allowing you to see everybody there.
Can we do this in the morning?
Oh, yeah, but,
And I'm sorry. I'm just really tired.
Okay. I've got the caterer all morning, and then I'm free in the afternoon.
Oh, we'll do it then.
Oh, yeah. Good night. Hey.
Yeah.
Is everything okay?
Absolutely.
Okay.
All right.
Whew! That was close. I mean, that was close. Sorry. Somehow I never imagined if I was in a bedroom with two women, they'd be discussing a seating chart. I'd be surrounded by dust bunnies.
Warren.
I know. I'm lucky to be in a bedroom with one woman.
You have to leave.
I do?
I'm serious. I'm here to help with the wedding party. I can't be fooling around. We can't be fooling around.
One kiss, then I'll go.
I don't believe you.
You're right. Two kisses, then I'm gone, I swear.
Warren.
I crossed my heart and hope to die.
No.
Fine, one kiss. See, we're back to one now. That's a compromise. I say one, I meant two.
Oh, my, get Willie Butch off the bed. The bouncing's making me sick.
Hey, bouncy, the room's been spitting all night.
Willie Butch, get down. Down, get down. Bad dog, get down. Oh, honey, feel my forehead.
You're fine.
I don't feel fine.
You're fine.
And somebody has to walk Willie Butch, honey.
I can't. I'm sick.
Well, Mike, I cannot walk him the way I feel.
Your idea to get a dog.
What makes you think you're so much sicker than me anyway?
What kind of question is that? I'm a doctor.
Yeah, well, obviously not a very good one, or you wouldn't have gotten yourself so sick.
I was trying to ask, but I'm not going to fall for that kind of logic. I've been in my weakened state. Even Sarah knows who's sicker.
Warren. Warren. Warren.
Hey, hey. Tell me I'm not dreaming.
You're not dreaming. And you're not staying. You gotta get out of here before Carol comes home.
What about breakfast?
Come on, you got 15 minutes.
Will I see you later?
Warren.
I just, one kiss, that's all I'm asking.
Yeah, Ed Stevens?
That's right.
Federal Marshal, I need to talk to you about your brother.
But Lloyd, what does the Federal Marshal want to talk about Lloyd for?
He was scheduled to surrender himself to prison 3 days ago. He didn't show.
No, that's got to be a mistake.
Well, could be, but in all my years of doing this, I've never seen it go that way.
I'm his lawyer as well as his brother. If you were in trouble, I would know.
I don't have any details. I only know he failed to report. That and the fact that he returned a rental trailer yesterday just up the road in Jaspertown, which is what brings me to you. Have you talked to him?
Well, if I had Marshall, that'd be a privileged conversation.
But you're a lawyer. I don't have to talk to you about aiding and abetting. Do you know where your brother is?
No, I don't.
If you see Lloyd, I'll expect to hear from you.
Sure.
Appointment.
I did, but he canceled. That's your excuse?
It's more like an explanation.
There is no explanation for this, Stella. You had sex with Warren Chaswick, a high school student. One of my high school students.
Former student. And not that this is any of your business, but how do you know I don't love him?
Yes.
I don't.
Of course you don't. He's Warren.
Hey.
We're both legal adults.
Oh, please, Stella, look at him. He keeps raising his hand.
Oh, it's just because I have a calculus test.
Sit down. I will write you a note. Tell me this is one of those one-time things.
Okay, it was a one-time thing.
Fine.
It happened two or three times.
All right, I have to be clean now. And I can't be clean because my shower's been ruined.
I'm not going to sit here and do this. I didn't do anything wrong.
Nothing wrong? You didn't do anything wrong? Ha! What?
I really do have to take a test.
Out! Get out! Wait a second. No.
If you tell anybody that you saw me naked, I swear to God, I will kill you.
I feel like I should be able to call you Carol now.
Go, go, go.
Lloyd, hey.
Hey, Eddie.
There you are. Hey, Lloyd, quick question for you. You miss any important appointments lately?
Well, like the dentist?
It's prison, Lloyd. I'm talking about prison. I just got a visit from a federal marshal.
What'd you tell him?
I told him I didn't know where you were.
He lied for me?
I didn't. I didn't lie exactly, Lloyd. When the guy asked me, I didn't know where you were.
Kind of splitting hairs a little there, aren't
Lloyd.
You, Eddie?
Lloyd, this is serious.
Come on. It's not like I hurt anybody. I got a little tax trouble. You know these accountant types. They forget to file a couple of times. It's like the end of the world.
What does that mean, a couple times? What does that mean, a couple? When's the last time you filed taxes, Lloyd?
95, I think they said.
1995?
You know, all these forms and papers, they just keep sending you this stuff.
Lloyd,
who understands it? I mean, seriously.
Why didn't you tell me about this? I can help you with things like this.
No, you know what? I got myself into this one. I'll get myself out.
You didn't get yourself out, though, like, did you? I got a visit from a federal marshal. Look, you're going to go to prison.
Come on, Eddie. It's no big deal. I want to know. All the criminals out there walking around the streets, you think Uncle Sam cares whether I do a couple of years?
What did you think, Lloyd? They're just going to forget? Is that what you thought?
You know what, Eddie? I mean, you're getting married. You got your own problems. Don't worry about it.
I'll make a couple of calls.
What?
I'll make a couple of calls to your life.
You do that.
Woo! All right, good.
That'd be good. Couple of calls. I don't think it's a big deal or anything. But if you made a couple of calls, I don't know why it would really hurt me in any way.
That is just wonderful.
Wonderful? Medical. I'm screwed here. I can't look Miss Fess in the face. Can't get a hold of Stella. I'm screwed. What are you talking about wonderful?
What do you want me to say? The wax melted and the wings came off.
What?
You flew too close to the sun, Icarus. Now you're paying for it.
Oh, everything was so awesome and now it just sucks.
Well, on the bright side, you got to have sex with a very hot woman and you saw Miss Vessie naked.
Silence, Sifu. What are you trying to get me killed?
Easy there, Bernadette Peters. So what did Ed say?
Oh, good God.
You haven't told him?
No, I hadn't even thought of that. Holy God, he's gonna kill me.
Well, that's something to look forward to.
No, I've already spoken to Mr. Cox and Agent Davis, so don't transfer. No, please, don't transfer me. Oh.
You're marrying into an outlaw family. I hope you realize that. Lloyd, it's gonna be an ex-con. As soon as he's finished being a con.
Stella slept with Warren.
Only stands reason you have to be a con before you can be an ex-con.
Did you even hear what I just said?
Yes, Stella slept with Warren. Well, Stella slept with Warren. So then Warren slept with Stella.
I am so unbelievably angry at her.
I'm stunned. Kind of nice for Warren, don't you think?
Ed!
Well, I can't help it. I'm impressed.
Really?
A little bit.
You still gonna be impressed when I tell you that he grabbed my butt in the shower?
Do what?
My naked butt.
Okay. Confused now. But still impressed. You
know, does anybody really buy this stuff?
Hey, you see that little counter in the corner of the screen? They're flying off the shelves.
Can we please watch something else?
Yeah, I'd love to. Anything.
So change it.
Okay, the remote's over there.
My God, Mike.
What would me?
You never walked Willie Butch, did you?
I thought you walked him.
No, I was busy getting our dog your job. You have to get up and clean the poop.
I'm too sick, Ed.
And I'm not? God, the smell's gonna make me throw up. Again.
The fact you can smell Willie Butch's poop proves that I'm worse off than you. See, I'm totally plugged up. I can't smell a thing.
Michael. Fine, you're such a baby. I will get up despite the fact that I have a fever and I am nauseous and I am feeling very faint. I will clean up the mess.
Honey, while you're up, can you grab me the remote, please? Thank you.
I think I can do it right now. 82, 83. What would we do? Without us, and there ain't no nothing we can't love each other through. What would we do, baby, without us?
Hi.
Sha-la-la-la.
Yeah, I'm looking for Ed Stevens. Not here.
Mr. Stevens won't be taking any new clients until he gets back from his honeymoon.
Oh, I'm not a client. CIO Ed, an apology. I tried to steal his girlfriend.
Really?
Oh, yeah. And I could have, but... So is he going to be around, or...?
No, but I'll let him know you were by.
Okay, great.
179 total. 34 size 8s, 42 9s, 49 10s, 39 11s, 14 12s, and one size 13. I have, of course, included the half sizes in the whole numbers.
Oh, amazing. I'm a numbers man myself, CPA, in fact. DeVry, class of 89. Oh, I'm Toby. Toby Gibbons.
Shirley. But you can call me Shirley.
You take the good, you take the bad, you take them both, and there you have the facts of life. The facts of life. There's a time you gotta go and show your glory.
Wow, it is cold out there. They said at the dress shop that we might have snow next week.
Well, is that what we do now?
What?
Talk about the weather.
We can talk about whatever you want.
Great, let's talk about you and Warren.
Except for that.
Stella, come on, we gotta resolve this.
Carol, it's done. It's over. Won't happen again. Besides, it's none of your business.
Oh! Yeah, actually, it became my business the minute Warren stepped in my shower.
Fine. You want me to be the bad guy? I'll be the bad guy. Can we drop this now?
No! No, Stella, we can't, because you obviously know you did something wrong. Otherwise, you wouldn't have hidden it from me.
I hid it from you because I knew how you would react.
Because you knew you were wrong. How could you do this to me?
Carol, I know this is difficult, but not everything is about you. Me and Warren, not about you.
Well, you made it about me when you brought him into my house.
You are not my mother. Stop acting like it.
I should have expected this. Should have expected it.
What does that mean?
It means, Stella, that I should have known you'd find a way to mess things up, because you always do.
Maybe I should just leave.
Fine.
Good luck with everything, Carol. Ugh.
Hey, Warren.
Hey, what's up, buddy? Bowling alley's looking good, huh?
Thank you.
Shoes, balls, pins. Balls, pins. Mm-hmm. Looking good. Cool sweater.
Thanks.
Jeez, man, we don't hang out enough. What's up with that?
Carol told me, Warren.
Huh?
Carol told me about you and Stella. She also told me about you and her.
Hey, you have to know it was completely unintentional. The Carol part, I mean, the Stella part, clearly some intention, but there was never any intention to lay a hand on your intended. I swear to God, those weren't my intentions.
You grabbed her naked behind, Warren.
Punch me in. Please punch me. I'm begging you to punch me in the face. Come on, now. Take it like a man. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Wait. Okay, go. Go, go, go. Punch me. Wait. Go.
Wait. Wait, can I talk to you in the office? Things don't look good. Well, they don't look good. I'm sorry. On the plus side, I managed to convince the prison authority you're not showing up was an honest mistake.
And it was!
Lloyd.
It could have been?
I bought you 24 hours, Lloyd, but then Marshall's going to be here tomorrow noon. You're going to have to turn yourself in.
No, Eddie. No, that can't happen. No. Here's what I was thinking. We'll pay the taxes back. I know it's a lot to ask, but if you can loan me the money.
It's not about the money.
It's always about the money.
Lloyd, that's not going to help this time. I'm sorry.
Well, did you ask for an appeal or a reprieve? Did you call the governor?
It's for a death sentence.
Eddie, this is the death sentence for me. I can't go to prison. Come on, don't quit now. Not when there's 24 hours, yeah?
I'll keep trying.
All right.
Come in.
George Fisher.
Ed Stevens.
Yeah, Ed Stevens, yeah, afraid so.
I'm incredibly curious to know what would bring you here today.
Oh, well, I have a bit of a situation. You're the only federal judge I could find on short notice, so.
Oh, please tell me you've come to ask a favor.
You're gonna make this as difficult as possible on me, aren't you?
Absolutely.
So I was kind of hoping by now we could put the past behind us, move on.
You don't know much about women, do you, Ed?
Tragically little, it seems.
I essentially threw myself at you. You turned me down.
And hell hath no fury like a woman scorned.
Scorned? Oh, is that what you think? You scorned me.
No. It was a quote. I was quoting. I like the quote. It was a ridiculous quote. I don't know. There was no scorning. I didn't scorn. No scorning.
Oh, you must be in a hell of a hole if you're coming to me.
Yeah, I am. It's family. And like I say, you're the only federal judge I knew was available. I mean, in a scheduling sort of. I don't mean sexually. I'm not talking sexually available. I didn't mean that.
Sit down, Ed.
I'll sit down.
All I wanted was a little quality quality time with my sister, and what do I get? Nudity, arguments, and Warren Cheswick in my shower.
I am so sorry.
Okay, tell me once again, especially that part where Warren grabs your butt.
Ew, Molly!
Okay. How can I help?
Oh, I don't think there's anything you can do.
Well, I am Warren's principal. I can make his life a living hell.
It's a mess. Actually, you know what? Can you meet me for coffee? I need to vent.
You just vented.
Yeah, but it's so much better in person.
When?
About an hour.
Actually, you know what? I'm gonna need a little bit more
time. Good. See you then.
Hello?
The science from before us, honey. Proof is in the mercury.
Yeah, bring it on. We'll see who's sicker.
Come on, what do you got?
101.
101? That's barely even low grade. Here, check out mine. That's high.
120? Oh, Mike, that's impossible. You'd be dead.
I've had a particularly hardy constitution.
Oh, my God. Did you stick your thermometer in your oatmeal?
Well, maybe your fever is higher. I think you might be getting delirious.
Mike, no, I can see the hole. Can't believe you cheated.
I didn't cheat. I just couldn't find a spoon.
Ugh, I need a neutral arbiter.
Okay, how about my mom?
Call Dr. Jerome.
Which Dr. Jerome?
Dr. Jerome.
Doesn't seem fair.
Mike!
Okay, fine, I'll call him.
I left as soon as I got your message. My dad says hi, by the way.
You told your father?
Well, I told him I was off to meet my lover, and after he stopped laughing, he said to say hello. What? I thought that was really mature of me, right? To call you my lover?
Warren.
Stella. Hi.
This is hard.
Wait. Oh.
I know where this is headed.
Okay, but before you go confessing your undying love, before you tell me how badly you want me, and I know that you do, it's a little obvious at this point. I'm trying to let you down easy here, and there's just no easy way to do this.
Go on.
Stella, I don't think we should see each other anymore. So please, no tears, okay, no begging. Let's just, come on. Let's dry off that face. Let's end this with our dignity, okay? Can we do that?
Okay. I'll try.
Good. I've just been thinking a lot about us lately, and I really don't think it's gonna work. Good God, woman, I mean, you're Miss Vessi's sister.
I know.
Good, okay. Are you okay?
I'm fine.
Okay, I'm sorry.
I gotta go.
Oh, okay.
One kiss, then I'll leave.
No problem.
You came through my get out of jail card, brother.
Couldn't help you, love. I'm sorry. I tried. I went over your case with a federal judge, which in and of itself was no picnic. There's no grounds for appeal, love.
So that's it?
That's not it completely. There's some good news. I got your sentence transferred to Clarkstown. Clarkstown Minimum Security Prison, Country Club Prison.
Country Club?
Yeah, it's like Club Fed. They actually call it that, Club Fed. You know, it's like Club Med, except the Med. You have till noon tomorrow, love, and then the marshal's coming. You're gonna have to go with him.
I should have known.
Should have known. What do you say?
Nothing. Forget it.
No, go ahead, Lloyd. Let's have it. Let's hear it.
I should have known you'd let me go to jail.
This is my fault. Is that what you're saying?
You want to know the real reason I didn't come to you when it all started? You want to know?
Yeah, go ahead. Go right ahead.
Because I knew how you'd react.
You're unbelievable. Do you know that?
See, there it is. There it is. There's that look.
Choices. Lloyd, people make choices that determine their lives. There's good and there's bad choices, and for some reason you consistently make bad choices.
You know what? I never should have come here. I should have gone to Costa Rica just like I planned. Then I wouldn't have to listen to your condescending crap. Thanks, Ed. Thanks for nothing.
So where's Stella now?
I don't know, probably off having a rant somewhere about how I'm so self-centered and controlling.
Well, you're just worried about her.
Mm. Yeah, well, somebody's got to. She doesn't think anything through. She just does whatever her heart desires, and she's always been this way. Frankly, I've been worrying about her since she was 7 years old.
Well, maybe it's time you stop. But she'll find her way. We all do eventually, right?
I came here to drink coffee and complain.
I know. Maybe next time.
$427. $501. $602.
Wow, it's amazing.
Thank you.
Let me ask you something. What are you doing here?
This is where I work.
No, I know, but why not get the HE double hockey sticks out of this backwater town? Share your gift with the world.
I enjoy the corn here.
I love corn.
Please write down the following numbers.
Yes, ma'am.
36. 47. 22.
I don't think this is gonna work, Phil.
Why?
I look nothing like that guy.
That's because you're Lloyd Stevens and I'm my cousin Everett. Here, keep these on. You'll pass. And when you get to the border, you're gonna go to the Cafe Gringo Verde. There you're gonna meet a man called Vamacuna. For enough pesos, he will take you all the way to Argentina. You'll be running in the pampas with the gauchos.
I don't think I wanna go all the way to Argentina.
He can also hook you up with an awesome spring break tour, too.
Oh, that'd be sweet.
What is this?
Phil. Eddie, look, I'm sorry about what I said earlier. You know I didn't mean it.
No, I know. It's okay. I understand. Listen, what's with this new look? What, you going somewhere?
I was thinking about heading down to Costa Rica.
Pardon?
I probably shouldn't say that, right? In case they ask. I'm going to Bolivia. That way, if they ask, you can say I said I was going to Bolivia. You wouldn't be lying.
But you're not going to Bolivia.
I know that.
You're not going to Costa Rica.
Eddie, you're getting married. Have a great wedding. I'll be fine.
No, Lloyd, it's not Lloyd. Lloyd, the wedding's not going to be fine. I'm worried about my brother.
So don't
worry. How can I not worry? You're my brother, Lloyd. You mean running around hiding out in some spider hole somewhere? It's all I'm going to be thinking about.
Come on.
Lloyd, I talked about choices. This is one of those choices. You have to make the right choice.
You really worry about me?
All the time.
All right. I'll turn myself in. I'll be here tomorrow.
Noon.
You have my word. Noon, tomorrow. Trust me, Eddie. I'll be here.
Stella?
Hey.
I'm sorry.
Don't apologize. You are right. I knew it was wrong to get involved with Warren. But I never did it to hurt you.
I know. I know.
It's just, Warren's sweet. He's kind. He never judges me, and I needed that.
I understand. And honey, I'm hard on you. No, but it's only because I worry. Listen, I need your life to be okay so I can stop worrying.
I'm all right, Carol. You don't have to worry about me.
Good. So, stay. Stay for my wedding. I can't get married without you.
I can't. Warren and I have a 7 o'clock bus to catch.
What?
I'm kidding.
Phil, have you seen Lloyd?
Am I your brother's keeper?
Phil!
Yeah, he was here a while ago.
He took the... Phil!
Was Lloyd in my office?
What, and I'm the security guard too?
Damn it, Lloyd.
Mr. Stevens.
Marshall, you're here early?
Yeah, I like to do that.
Don't suppose you're here to ball.
20-some years in this business, it almost always comes down the final hour. Things are gonna go bad. That's when it happens. Things haven't gone bad, have they? I'm gonna have to call him in.
Marshall. Let me know if you hear anything, will you?
Mrs. Burton, let's see what we have here. Maybe a little bit red, but not congested?
No, not really.
No, I'm congested.
Yeah, just because I'm not congested does not mean I'm not sick.
You're not congested, but you do have an upset stomach.
Yes, it comes and goes. Did I mention fatigue? I am wiped out.
Would you like an early diagnosis?
Oh, okay.
You have a chronic case of being an excellent patient. Here we go.
I'd like to add that I'm achy, Dr. Jerome. I'm extremely achy.
Right. All right, Dr. Burton, your turn.
You know, anything about being achy, lady.
Let's watch the trash talk, son. All righty, let's get this started. Now, which hole does this block go in? Very good. Very good.
Don't forget, I know I couldn't count on you being fair.
Relax, Michael. I was just trying to make this fun. Sit down. Let's find out what's wrong with you.
You have to grin.
That's why I look like one of Makey.
Okay, can we take a 2-minute time out from the tonsil hockey, please? I need a word with the Shirley Bird.
1 moment, please. Yes.
Bad news. I was checking your figures on the shoes and inventory and stuff. It's way off, okay? Al Gore might not have, but I am definitely going to demand a recount.
I made all those numbers up.
What? Really?
Entirely fabricated.
Phil, can we have a moment?
Are you mad? I would understand if you were mad because I did lie, but really, if you think about it... Why are you doing that?
No talking. I'm not mad. Come on, let's get some burgers.
Or maybe apples?
Sure, we can get some apples.
Oh, this is ridiculous. Having a contest to see who's sicker. Should we just go home?
No way.
You're going down, faker.
Reports are in. Let's start with you, Dr. Burton.
Yes!
Well, yes.
They always announce the runner-up first.
I know this is real important, but I do have patients to heal. Dr. Burton, you have an acute cold.
Crap.
Mm-hmm. An acute cold with a complex flu virus.
Awesome.
You should be out of the woods in a day or two. However, Mrs. Burton, you have just entered the forest.
Okay, what does that mean?
You're going to be down and out for about 8 or 9 months.
8 or 9 months?
You're pregnant.
What?
What?
Congratulations.
I can't believe I didn't know.
Well, how could you? It's not as if you were married to a real physician or anything.
That's a good one.
Thank you.
Before we jump ahead here, can I just point out that I win the contest? You know, pregnancy, while a beautiful miracle, it's not an illness.
All right, you relax for the next day. I got you for the next 9 months. I can't believe I'm pregnant.
Why would he do something like this? Well, I'll tell you why. Because he's Lloyd, that's why.
I'm sorry. I wish there was something I could say.
This is Ed. Where is he? Okay, right. No, thank you. Thank you.
They found him.
Found his car downtown somewhere near the bus station.
Well, then he's gone.
Well, let's hope not.
Oh, no! Oh, what are you doing? Don't do that. It's not like this. Not in front of everybody, please. Hey, what's going on? I thought you said I had to loan.
Were you going
to
be there at noon, Lloyd?
I gave you my word.
Well, why'd you take the baseball then?
I took the baseball to a collector so I could sell it to buy you two a present. See?
I'm not lying.
Uncuff him. Uncuff him, please. He has till noon.
I'm sorry, Brian. Oh, sorry, Eddie. I understand. Hey, better open that present. I'm a little short on time.
Yeah, of course. It's a...
It's a vacuum.
No, it's not just a vacuum. It's an automatic vacuum, Eddie. Just turn it on, sit back, relax, enjoy the ride. This don't guarantee a happy marriage. Nothing will.
Thank you, Lloyd. We're gonna miss you.
I bet you will.
You're gonna be all right. You're gonna be just fine.
Yeah, I know I will. Club Fed, right?
Yeah, Club Fed.
Hey, make some contacts in there, Eddie. You know, one of those rich business guys? Come out the other end with some prospects. Prospects, Eddie!
My money's on you, Lloyd.